You do do do. Hello again, YouTube. I am in midst of return of another sketchbook tour. And I'll put it on Instagram that I get it out by tomorrow morning. It is 11 at night. And so, let's just start it up, I guess. So, this front page is just, I don't know, a lot of information on it that it doesn't really need to be there. Let me cover this up. I think I'll just start the footage right here. I don't know. The number's not there. You didn't see it. I was using my ink pens that I made. It's with acrylic ink that you buy from Michaels. I want to get it and use it. And part of me, if I do kind of like marker all while I'm talking, it's the way to keep me from rambling. You know, just thinking and coloring in the pages. Yeah. So I was using new markers, and it's not really a new marker. It's an ink pen that I made with one of the water aqua jets or aqua flash watercolor pens, and you know, this is it, like the blue. I liked it, but it stopped up. And you'll see a lot of that in the sketchbook. Some figure drawings. Oh, gesture drawing practices. These are really bad. There are some pretty good ones drawn in the middle of these, in between them. After a while, I don't think, yeah. I had to move this around by hand today. So you know what? This is just a whole camera. That's better. Sketchbook, it has a lot of figure drawings in it. Gesture drawings, because I'm trying to learn gesture and draw the form. This is a speed paint. I think I put on YouTube. I probably did. I don't know. I don't remember. Probably not, though. This is one of the better looking ones right here that I got done. And gesture drawing was kind of hard in the beginning because learning how to follow gesture took me a long time. It's still kind of hard. But I feel like I'm getting a better knack for it more than I did before. At least like getting people to see it pose what I'm doing, the gestures. It's hard. And I try to write down the dates in the book. But sometimes I forget to write down the dates in the books. You all still can't see. I think that's pretty good. Yeah, there's some times, you know, I don't get it. But I think I try to do my very best to get a good enough gist of the gesture drawings. My dad, he draws too, but he has like floor plans and stuff like that. This one is a concept for a painting I'm thinking about. I thought about trying to do like a difference in masculinity and femininity, but I don't know enough about the topic. Just flat and start drawing about it. So, I don't know. I'm still thinking about it. It's a lot. But you said use the ink pen, and I still am not. I don't know. I just scribbled it together to try to help myself see it. But a lot of, and the time really correct stuff going on to the point where I can't fix it right now. So. Same here. Thinking of ideas and whatnot. These sketches are bad. Well, your sketchbook is not supposed to look good by any means. You know, just poses and stuff. These are my figure drawings towards the end of the other night. These are the pretty good looking ones. These ones are, yeah. These are the pretty good looking ones. Started to get like an understanding of form, shoulders and stuff like that. This is my friend Sierra L. Cray. This is their art name they drew in the sketchbook because they were waiting on me to go to the movies, and I was taking too long, so I was like, you can just do this, and that's what happened. That's what you do with your friends. You let them sketch in your sketchbooks. This pose was ridiculous. Oh my god. This pose, it caused me stress. It caused me dementia because there was no way to draw it from the computer. I would have to give them a piece of paper. I just didn't feel comfortable in drawing it. Even when I did like the shape, you know, I got the gesture, the character, or the person. I'm gonna call it a character. It's just difficult, but for what it is, it's done now. Yeah, it really like messed me up. These are my ink splotch fishes because I didn't, because as I told you, a lot of practice going on with the ink pen, and I didn't know what to do with the splotches. And one of my friends was like, "Yeah, you just make something out of them." So I did. I made like little ink splotch fishes and whatnot. So it's odd, it's different. I normally don't draw like this, but hey, imagination leads to some level of creativity, I guess. And then it's kind of weird because I have ideas for each of these individually, but I don't know what I'm gonna do with them just yet. I had to think about maybe make it into a big animation with this part and period. Don't know. That's a little wormy guy. Some questions. Very tired. I was practicing with the ink pen that I made, and this is the idea for a painting I'm coming up with. This sketchbook, it has a very large, very broad time skip in it because I lost it and I found it again. But this was the final product I had come up with. It's supposed to represent dying and learning to come to peace with the fact that it's happening. A lot of deaths in my family lately, and I'm trying to eat a piece to help me cope with what was going on at the time. I still do, but God is good, so I'm learning to get not over the death, but learning how to deal with him in a proper manner. But these were beginning sketches. Like, I didn't know if I wanted her to be a human or a bug person. I didn't know which way I wanted her to look and stuff like that. I went to the museum in Norfolk, and I tried to copy, well, I tried to get the better portion of the gesture down for Prometheus, I think it was. I think it was like he took fire from the heavens and brought it down for people to use. And in return, a crow was bid to bite him in the eye forever. Yeah, it's supposed to be like a car. Big mean crow. Well, this is some type of bird. Cow. this is another thing I did with these brush pens. I was trying to learn how to use them, so I didn't think too much. I just did a little thing, like a little doodle. I don't know what I'm gonna call it. Doodle. I wish I could talk more like about, oh, this is my technique. I don't have one. I kind of just go with the flow, you know, whatever comes to my heart and my mind. This is kind of what I put on paper, like a little warm up things. And then this is where my sketchbook starts to get interesting. So, I think this is towards the middle and the end of the book, because I'm only doing half of it, and then when I'm done with the other half, I'll show you the rest. But this is me, Whitney, Brandon, and my friend Sierra, the one who did the pages with the blue person on it. This is her drawing, and we were at the mall, and some gory stuff right here, and then this, and I have, this is the speed paint. For last week's video, the week before last video, and yeah, you know, I enjoyed painting this. It was my first real serious watercolor. Everybody asks who this is. It doesn't have a name. Not yet. I'll name him sooner or later. But yeah, if you can't tell, I turn all my little splotches and mistakes into fish or something. I don't know, it just makes them useful other than just being a thing in the sketchbook. Because this does look like a sea of fish right here, because the way I always test my colors down here. So, yeah, and this is like the only good two pages synonymously in my sketchbook. And then I painted a mushroom thing and just grass, I guess. I don't know, it looks bad. Me and my friends went out to get coffee that day, and this was a sketch that I put on Instagram to just say, hey, I'm not dead, I'm doing something, but I need a little bit of time right now because I need to, you know, like, get it done. And honestly, at that period of time, at that moment, it was like 2 or 3 days ago, I didn't need more time. I needed a lot of time to get everything done that I wanted to. I'm still doing the anatomy practice. I'm still trying to learn stuff, and I don't think I'm very good at it still. There's a lot of practice I need to do, because that's why I normally just stick to like this region of the body. At least I can like fake a face until I make it, and everywhere else I gotta like seriously think about it. But yeah, this one doesn't have any like fantastic portraits in it. Even when I do my watercolor sketchbook tour, you'll see like portraits. I do all my portraits freehand. I don't grid or trace. Sometimes they come out looking good, sometimes they come out looking terrible. But this one in particular, this guy, I might like fix him, because yeah, it's a lot of problems. But nonetheless, on to the next page. Oh yeah, for Christmas, my family got me the pens like this, and so I wanted to kind of play with them a little bit. Ignore this hand. This was a 5 a.m. hand, and it didn't really need to be there. But I did like a tie. I never try not to draw too tired. Like I have commissions. I'm like, okay, be awake when you're doing it. Don't be super tired. So I tried to do like a simple portrait of my friend with these markers. I did these, and I just tried to get like the main shadows. He liked it. And oh wait, it's this guy right here. This the Asian man. That dude. All right, I can't put my finger into the camera. Oh. There, I think the Asian man, yeah. So, oh no, wrong page. I'm tired. That's him, and I know there's a lot more detail I could go into. And then these are just figure drawings. And I let my nephew draw my sketchbook sometimes too. He wants to learn how to draw, thinks his uncle is amazing, but I think I'm terrible. Now, I should wrap this up with a drawing, right? But it is 11:06, and I think the sketchbook tour was only like 8 minutes. This is half of the text under the sketchbook. Literally, let me just pull out the bottom so you all can see it. This is only half of the sketchbook, and I'm gonna paint this part of the sketchbook and do like effects with it to the best of my ability. So, yeah. But thank you for joining me on another sketchbook tour. I started this in October of 2016, October, November, December, and now it's January. It's been here too long. The last one, that was super quick, 2 months. And I've been drawing every day, but now I have like a portable sketchbook with other drawings, other really bad and really okay. Let me see if I can find you guys one I like. No, I use my markers in here sometimes. Like this one, I did this one long ago. You know, people just sitting at a bench. I'm still figuring things out, but do her. Literally wanted her to seem creepy, and I do like these guys. I'm in school waiting on my professor to come in. So, and there's supposed to be a bunch of people at the table, but I never finished it. That was not that whole book. And this is watercolor. This is a watercolor book too. You can take it as you go. So thank you so much for joining me on this halfway sketchbook tour. If you like it, comment, subscribble, you know, subscribe. If you want to, I can't make you, but do if you want to. Thank you so much for joining me in this period of my time, and I'm blessed to have you all here. Thank you guys. So stay up, stay safe, and be blessed. Bye.